What does a factory do? Oh boy. Well, we make a lot of stuff here.
Factory's been around for 10 years. We opened in 2013, March, on my birthday, in fact. We joked that Louie got me a company for my birthday.
Paul and I met at Cranbrook Academy of Art in Michigan.
We were both in the sculpture department. That's kind of where our friendship started. After graduating, moved to New York. I think I kind of convinced Louie to move to New York and come work in the fashion photography, set, and event industry.
Neither one of us are traditionalist sculptors. We're really artists, and we work in a variety of materials. That really translates well to set and event fabrication.
We worked for another company for a number of years. We thought that we could be successful at trying it on our own. In the beginning, hunger had a lot to do with our ability to tell any client that we're capable of doing anything that they want us to. Even if it's a false bravado, it's a level of confidence in yourself and your ability to adapt and learn very quickly that really made this company possible.
That first year was really tough. The second year we made a profit. The third year we doubled. The fourth year we doubled again. The fifth year we doubled again. Before, we were doing a lot of magazine photo shoots, advertising and editorials, small stuff. And then the rest is history. Experiential marketing blew the doors off of everything that we were doing here. And it's also like a lot more fun.
We don't create and build the same thing every day, and that's where we excel, and that's what kind of sets us apart from a more traditional fabrication shop.
The biggest challenge was just starting. Just telling yourself, like, get out of the comfortable zone and just go for it.
We really scrapped together whatever Louie and I had in savings, enough to buy us a couple of months on the lease and the bare minimum amount of tools that we need. We had to dump whatever money we had into our next investment in order to grow the company. So that meant taking a huge leap of faith.
I went home and I talked to my wife about it because Paul and I were, you know, we were mulling it over. We were like, man, I think we could do this. And I'm like, how do we pay for it? I don't know, we'll figure it out. I went home and I talked to my wife and I said, I can keep the job I have now. It's a good one. It's a little stressful, but it pays for everything we need. Or I can go take a shot at doing our own thing. And you're not gonna see me much. I don't think you're gonna see me much at all for a few years. And she said, Louie, I'll support you if you stay at the job that you have, but I'll support you more if you, but I'll support you more if you go out on your own. So go do it.
Equipment investment is a huge part of what we've done. And now we've really kind of recognized the future of 3D printing and digital fabrication tools. It's making our work more efficient. It's making our products better.
We have a massive 3D printer. It looks like a giant microwave oven. The objects that it can print in a single go are 4 feet deep, roughly 5 feet wide, 6 feet tall. The internet is essential to what we're doing here. We use cloud-based storage and cloud-based transfer for just about everything that we do.
The ability to share information immediately and to watch someone work on something simultaneously as you is huge. I mean, it's a game changer. All the information that we share with clients and also with all the team here at the factory is usually under lock and key. And because of the amount of digital work that we do and the amount of work we do on the cloud software, the cybersecurity is a huge, huge part of us keeping our clients' information safe, keeping our business safe. Our staff here is one of the features of our company that we're most proud of. We search for the highest skilled possible people for whatever position that we need to have filled. And once we get these people here, we do everything that we can to keep them.
It's not boring, and work can be very boring. We're not an assembly line business. We're not installing doors on cars over and over and over again. That's not fulfilling enough for a lot of creative people. This is kind of that creative incubator for us. That's what we hope we're creating.
One of the reasons that we did start this company is because we wanted the space, equipment, tools, materials to be able to continue our art practice. And we find that same mentality translates into our employees as well, because we know that's a vital part of their lives. And that's the kind of people that we want to attract and who we want to work with. We like to think that we're one of the best in the business. In order for us to continue to grow and expand, we'll have to go into new markets.
I know that I always want to make something bigger and better and cooler.
We're addicted to growing our business.
We like to make cool stuff. That's really what we want to do. And so why do we just have to make it in New York, right? Why can't we make it in Vegas and LA and Miami, somebody's got to do it.